Sorry. I remember, so we did a pre-shoot, we did like a test, and a lot of things became quite clear during that test. One, I have these really big, like, sweet guy ears, apparently, and, you know, like a very kind of innocent-ish face, which betrays everything about this character that I'm supposed to be doing. So I think we just kind of sat and looked in the mirror and was like, how do we, you know what I mean? Like, how does this work? It was very clear instantly. It was like, we've got to put on some weight. You got to just chuck on as much as you can. And we kind of did that. We even came up with this thing where we tried to, like, stick these ears back so that it became much more of, like, a clinical kind of cranium in that way. Like, it was just kind of straight. And then we couldn't ever do reverses of my shoulder because you would see this thing in the back of my ear, so that didn't work. We then tried a bunch of different teeth. I was hesitant about teeth, but then we molded Brian's teeth, and I put them in my mouth. So I'm wearing Brian's actual teeth, which is amazing. And all that was kind of coming together, and obviously the tattoos are the tattoos. You can't escape that. That's always going to be part of it. But and the shaving the head, of course, absolutely, yeah, and that does change a person instantly, for sure. But then as soon as we put these, like, darker contacts in my eyes, as soon as, like, the dark, just the hollowness of these eyes start piercing through with this kind of snaggle tooth poking out, this character kind of he became like a shark, like this vicious predator that was kind of detached from your feelings and didn't care about how it made you feel. The whole point of it was about intimidation. The whole reason he could put this on his face was that he didn't want to talk to you. He wanted you to be afraid. That's a very powerful thing. These guys and these movements, they thrive off of this feeling of making you feel less than and making you feel scared. And it's power. I mean, we would go out to lunch sometimes in this very lovely town of Kingston, upstate New York, and I'd be like, give me some eggs, please. And they'd be like, okay, hon, how would you like your eggs? And she wouldn't look at me. And I'd be like, I want them scrambled, please. Just looking right at her. And I think when humans interact with something that they're terrified of, they want to pretend it doesn't exist. There's an unwillingness to confront it. They don't want to see it. And it goes to the shadow, you know, it doesn't happen. But I certainly got a sense of, like, if I looked at someone, they were terrified of me. I've never, ever, ever had that before in my life. People usually look at me and they go, oh, he's that little kid from that movie. So sweet. You know, that's basically my life. So this is very different, you know. And that ultimately is the whole point. It really is.